Greetings, pilots and passengers. If you haven't heard already, Freemasons perform all kinds of freaky and weird rituals to climb up the ranks. Of course, the majority of their rituals are hidden behind closed doors, because there's nothing dodgy going on in there, is there? I just like to think they meet up every now and again in the little white gloves and white apron, they whip the wangs out and they compare sizes and all that sort of thing. Unless they want to come out and correct me. Luckily, the selfless Freemasons have let out a couple of their rituals. Just a little teaser of what new members can expect when they sell their soul. Unfortunately for the Freemasons, some ex-Freemasons have come out in previous years exposing the truth of what goes on behind the closed doors. Now, sources differ on what occurs in initiation ceremonies. Some sources suggest that things that take place in certain rituals may come earlier or they don't occur in that ritual, while others suggest that they come later. It's all a bit confusing. So, let's take a look at the first initiation ceremony. It's argued that this is the initiation ceremony, whereas others say that this is the first degree ceremony. I'm a bit confused, but I'm not a Freemason, so I wouldn't know. This ritual takes place for newly accepted brothers who are wanting to start their journey and become enlightened on their transition into the cult. Masons who make it through this journey become an entered apprentice. So basically, it is the first degree of initiation, or the first degree, I don't know. It's confusing. The sources are so conflicting. The poor lad who's wanting to become a Mason must accept the Masonic Lodge rules and the rules of Freemasonry. All that rubbish about being a really good person, serving God, donating to charity, being philanthropic, you know, being a really selfless member of the community and wanting to serve others. Because Masons really love their community and totally aren't showing how much they donate to charity to make themselves feel better about that baby they sacrificed earlier. You know, yin and yang and all that. The most important law a Freemason must accept is pinky promising that they won't let out any Freemason secrets, because that would be a really big oopsie. Wouldn't want to let out the Masonic plans for a new world order, would we, eh? Oh, wait. Plus, they must swear to protect their brothers at any and all costs, no matter what. This involves crime, from speeding all the way up to assault, crimes against children, even murder, you know, everything in between that. Having friends in high places is just one pro of being a Mason. It acts as a really great get out of jail free card. The Masons have done plenty of media features and documentaries showcasing what goes on in the initiation ceremony, but what are the chances they've left out all of the best bits? For example, the text from the small black, the craft book, and the red, Royal Arch books, detail the following from rituals. A Mason must promise not to learn to write, speak, or tell anyone else anything about what they've learned through Freemasonry, so that their secret arts and hidden mysteries may improperly become known through their unworthiness. If they leak any Freemasonry secrets, they must accept that. On the violation of any of them, then that of having my throat cut across, my tongue torn out by the root and buried in the sand of the sea at low water mark, or a cable's length from the shore, where the tide regularly ebbs and flows twice in 24 hours, or the more effective punishment of being branded as a willfully perjured individual. Now, if that punishment doesn't sound like a weird ritual in itself, then I don't know what to say to you. Of course, the Masons like to sort of argue like, oh, that was from years ago. You know, it's not literal. Nowadays, we don't do that. It's just metaphorical. When I was researching this, the sources that I used were really conflicting. I used a very mainstream source, and that was kind of like, oh, the first ceremony, they say things. The second ceremony is when things ramp up a little bit. But the other source I used said the opposite, that from the very start, they're doing a lot of like performances, ceremonies, rituals, and it's all very strange from the start. I see it as taking bits and bobs of truth from everywhere. I'm not just gonna say one source is entirely accurate, but the sources which included the Masonic text, I'm gonna say yeah, because that is taken from the text itself. Now, things ramp up a bit at the second degree of initiation. This is coming from the very mainstream source, which is classroom. Masons who make it this far earn the fellow craft degree, which is classed as the second degree of Freemasonry, where some have argued that this is actually just the second initiation, so you're not actually in yet. But I would like to say that it is probably the second degree. The candidate must be blindfolded and have a rope around his neck or his arm. It's very specific and it's argued that it varies amongst different lodges, but I doubt this. I don't know why they would change it per lodge. Then the right trouser leg is rolled up until the knee is exposed and a shoe is placed on the left foot. So far, this guy's looking like a right wally, so if that's what they were going for, then they're doing all right. They can keep going on with that. To enter the lodge, the candidate must knock on the door 3 times, which to me symbolises the Holy Trinity. In that case, they could be mocking it. It's totally just a coincidence, isn't it? This ritual allegedly focuses on discussions of metaphorical stuff and all the deep things to help the candidate bond with the other members of the lodge. I don't know how much crazier you can get with a noose around your neck and your blooming trouser leg rolled up. Leaked Masonic texts detail that the candidate must perform a ceremony of passing, which involves learning and repeating passwords and wandering around the lodge in a clockwise trajectory. Again, the candidate must solemnly swear not to leak any of the Masonic secrets because on the violation of any of them, then that of having my left breast laid open, my heart torn therefrom and given to the ravenous birds of the air, or devouring beasts of the field as prey. Again, it's very weird, and they would say, oh, it's just metaphorical, it's nothing weird, we're not actually having anything torn out from us or anything. But how do we know? We're not Masons. For the third degree ritual, again, I'm using the source of the Masonic text, which got leaked onto this website. This ritual is called the Raising. Again, the candidate must knock on the door, but use a special knock that they learnt from the second degree ritual. From what I've read and researched from the source that I'm using, and I'll link all the sources down below in the description, it sounds like they're performing a really bad play every single time, and I'm pretty sure my school nativity was better than this. The candidate must repeat passwords they have learnt from previous initiations, and then learn further passwords and hand signs to prove that they are ready to be initiated onto the next step. These code words include Boaz, so they'll spell it out like B-O-A-Z, and Jachin, J-A-C-H-I-N. Of course, Bozo or B-O-Z-O would have been a better one and they should have used that. Another oath is repeated and said during this ceremony. They must agree that they will be readily available as a Freemason, so if they are summoned to the lodge at any time, that they will go and attend meetings that they are required to attend. They again must swear to protect all Masonic secrets they are entrusted with. This includes the further protection of their fellow brothers. That my breast shall be the sacred repository of his secrets when entrusted to my care, murder, treason, felony, and all other offences contrary to the laws of God and the ordinances of the realm, being at all times most especially accepted. I think that what they're trying to get across here is they're allowed to commit certain crimes and get away with it, except for crimes such as murder and treason. Them crimes are reserved for those higher up. They can get away with that sort of thing. If you're lower down, you can't. I love the punishment for the third degree. It's my favourite one so far. On the violation of any of them, than that I've been 7 in 2, my body burnt to ashes, and those ashes scattered over the face of earth and water by the 4 cardinal winds of heaven, that no trace or remembrance of so a vile wretch may longer be found among men, particularly Master Masons. It's always so specific, like it can't be 3 cardinal winds, it has to be 4. And if they're scouring the ashes, it has to be over earth and water, it can't just be earth or water. It's just another ritual to them. Like, it's so obvious it's just another ritual because of the way it's worded. It's so intricate and detailed, like overly detailed. Once they've said an oath and done this weird play ritual thing, which involves a lot of walking around windy staircases that don't exist, walking to corners of the room, you know, north, east, south, west, being told new passwords, being told new grips, handshakes, symbols and signs that they can use to talk and communicate amongst each other. Once they've done all that, they go into something called the charge. And this one stood out to me quite a bit. The charge is a reading read out by the worshipful master. Here's a sample from the charge that I got from a leaked Masonic text. Let me now beg you to observe that the light of a Master Mason is darkness visible. serving only to express that gloom which rests on the prospect of futurity. Now, this is my interpretation, so I'm probably not entirely correct here. It sounds like they're saying the light within a Mason is dark. They don't work in love and light and are seeking the best for humanity. It's as though they are giving subtle hints to the candidate that the path they are going to be going down is quite dark. Further down the charge, the worshipful master says, "The Lord of Life will enable us to trample the King of Terrors beneath our feet and lift our eyes to that bright morning star, whose rising brings peace and salvation to the faithful and obedient of the human race." Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but that sounds like a reference to Satan. Morning Star is known as another term and name for the devil. And here they have suggested that the rising of the Morning Star, so you could interpret that as Satan, will bring peace and salvation to those only who are faithful and obedient. No prayers or anything like that that they were doing in the first degree initiation. Nah, that's all out the window at this point. From my research, it appears some lodges may require a prospective Mason to complete more than one initiation ceremony to become a Freemason, whilst others may require just one ceremony. Of course, none of this can be confirmed because only those practicing Freemasonry will know the truth. It's confusing, it's frustrating and annoying, but until the truth is exposed, that is just the way things are going to be. From what I understand, the first initiation is the first degree. Some sources I've been reading have said otherwise. It's all very confusing. What is certain though, is the secrecy surrounding these rituals, and the fact that these ceremonies do involve performances. I would not be surprised if these rituals did have some sort of effect, as from what I've read, they're often performing hand signs, they're reading out these oaths and these really long bits of text, reciting prayers and using wands. I really look forward to the day that Freemasonry is exposed and can no longer hide any of its secrets. We deserve to know what is truly going on behind them closed doors. We deserve to know the truth of the rituals that they perform. On that note, if you want to help in the fight against Freemasonry, subscribe to Dare to Fly today and get ready to take flight. Knowing is enough, and by knowing, you can spread the message and tell others about what is going on. Remember, we need to reboot the world. And as always, fly high, fearless, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video.